Merchant of Venice, Act 1, Scene 2, page number 32. We have done till line number 40. So we will start with line number 41. Portia says here, I pray thee, overname them, and as thou namest them, I will describe them, and according to my description, level at my affection. See here, what is Portia telling? That I request you, please call out their names, and as you call out their names, I will describe them, and according to my description, you can guess my feeling towards them. Then there is a, she starts with the first one. She says, first there is the Neapolitan prince. Neapolitan prince means the prince from Naples. So Portia, what does she say about him? She says, that's a fault indeed, for he doth nothing but talk of his horse, and he makes it a great appropriation to his own good parts that he can shoe him himself. See here, the Neapolitan prince, Portia says, he is just like a young horse because he does nothing but talk of his horse. Okay, and he makes it sound as if it is an addition to his own merits that he can shoe his own horse. So what is a colt? Colt is used for the prince as he is a young fellow who is rough and inexperienced, just like a young horse. So the people of Naples, at that time, the people of Naples, they were famous for their horsemanship. So after that, Nerissa says, then is there the County Palatine. So Portia, what is her view of County Palatine or Count Palatine? She says, he doth nothing but frown, as who should say, and you will not have me choose. He hears merry tales and smiles not. I fear he will prove the weeping philosopher when he grows old, being so full of unmannerly sadness in his youth. I had rather he married to a death's head with a bone in his mouth than to either of these. God, defend me from these two. So Portia, she says that, saying about whom? County Palatine. So she says that he does nothing but frown, as if he were to say, if you will not have me, choose anyone that you want. And he hears merry tales, means the funny tales, and does not smile. So line number 54, you can see, Portia, she further says that she fears he will become the weeping philosopher when he grows old. Why she says this? Because as he is so full of sadness in his youth. She said that she would rather be married to a skull with a bone in his mouth than to either of these. Either of these means, she says that she would prefer not to be married to whom? The Prince of Naples or Count Palatine. And then she further says, may God protect her from these two. Then Nerissa, she is asking about the third suitor. How say you by the French Lord Monsieur Libon? Portia then says, God made him, and therefore let him pass for a man. In truth, I know it is a sin to be a mocker, but he hath a horse better than the Neapolitans, a better bad habit of frowning than the Count Palatine. He is every man in no man. If a throstle sing, he falls straight a capering, he will fence with his own shadow. So here, what is she saying about whom? the French lord Monsieur Le Bon. Portia says that as God has made him, so let him be accepted as a man, because it is sinful to mock people. And then she said, but he has a better horse than whom? Than whose? Than the Neapolitans. And she further says that he has a worse habit of frowning than the Count Palatine. And he has the personality of every man, but has none of his own. And then she further says that if a throstle, what is a throstle? You can see in the notes. It is a thrush. Thrush means a bird, an English bird that sings. So here she says that if a thrush sings, what does the French lord do? He starts jumping up and down to the music. Okay. And then he draws. If a throstle sings, he falls straight a capering. He will fence with his own shadow. If I should marry him, I should marry 20 husbands. If he would despise me, I would forgive him. For if he love me to madness, I shall never requite him. So here she further says that he draws out his sword and duel with his own shadow. So here, what does he do? When he sees his own shadow, he takes out his sword and he starts fighting with his shadow. Then she says that if she married him, then it would be just like what? Marrying 20 husbands. And if he would despise her, means hate her, she would forgive him for that, for hating her. But if he loved her madly, she would never be able to return his love. Then here, Nerissa says, what say you then to Falconbridge, the young Baron of England? He is a fourth suitor. Portia says that, you know, I say nothing to him, for he understands not me, nor I him. He hath neither Latin, French, nor Italian, and you will come into the court and swear that I have a poor pennyworth in the English. So here, what is Portia saying that? Portia said nothing to whom? Nothing to him. Whom? Falconbridge, the young Baron of England. Why? She said nothing to him because he did not understand her and she did not understand what he said. Why she is saying this? Because he neither knew Latin nor French nor Italian. And Portia, okay, she did not understand English. Then here she says that he is a proper man's picture, but alas, who can converse with a dumb show? How oddly he is suited. I think he bought his doublet in Italy, his round horse in France, his bonnet in Germany, and his behavior everywhere. So here she says that he is a man of fine what? Appearance, means he is a good looking person, but who could talk with a mind? And then she further says that that he was very strangely dressed. She thought that he had bought his jacket from where? From Italy. Means his appearance was so strange that she felt that he bought his jacket from Italy, his breeches in France, and his hat in Germany. And if you asked about his manner was from everywhere, from all these places. Then Nerissa asked, what think you of the Scottish lord, his neighbor? Portia says that he hath a neighborly charity in him, for he borrowed a box of the ear of the Englishman and swore he would pay him again when he was able. I think the Frenchman became his surety and sealed under for another. So here she says that he is very generous towards his neighbor. Why she says this? Because he was given a punch in his face, where close to his ear, by the Englishman, and he swore that he would repay him when he could. And the Frenchman, he guaranteed that he would repay the debt and signed his name underneath the Scotsman as the guarantor. Okay, so here we have completed till the fifth suitor. Now the sixth one. How like you the young German, the Duke of Saxony's nephew? Then Portia says, very wildly in the morning when he is sober, and most wildly in the afternoon when he is drunk. So yeah, what is Portia's opinion about the German Duke of Saxony's nephew? She says that he is what? He is very badly. Okay, his condition is very bad when in the morning when he is sober. And his condition is even still worse in the afternoon when he is drunk. When he is best, he is a little worse than a man, and when he is worst, he is little better than a beast. So here she further says that when he is at his best, then how is his condition? He is little worse than a man, and when he is at his worst, means when he is completely drunk, he is a little better than a beast. Then she further says that, and the worst fall that ever fell, I hope I shall make shift to go without him. And then she further says is, if the worst thing that could happen should happen. And then she says that she shall manage to go without him. So we will do till here line number 101. In the next class we will continue further. And if you go through your workbook, you will find question answers from all these extracts. Okay, the passage, the portion that we have completed.